Hello everyone, welcome to another Tooltip Tuesday. In this episode, we will discuss BlankX software, which is used on the CPX blank winding machine, and one of the features which is called as the spindle speed variation. Now, while selecting this option here, it is categorized under the wheel spin section. This is where you can specify the finishing wheel to rotate clockwise or anti-clockwise, get your grind point, do down grind or up grind. Now, we may have noticed sometimes when we do the wheel grinding, happens on the surface finish where it looks like a fish scale pattern, and we may also have knowledge about using the RPM into a prime number. This is to keep your wheel RPM and headstock RPM not multiple or divisible by each other. So the spindle speed variation is one of the features what Anka has introduced on the blank grinder, where grinding RPM is oscillating like a sine wave. This feature is available both for roughing and for finishing wheel, and I will just quickly show you by selecting and deselecting the button here for the roughing wheel. So there are three main parameters the user need to input. The first one is the amplitude, which is the variation in RPM from the nominal. So for example, if your roughing spindle is running at 6000 RPM, you can specify how much you want to increase from 6000 and decrease from 6000, and that is this RPM here. So you can see in the plot here, the line in the middle is your nominal, and the line on the top and bottom is basically the amplitude. The next one is the period, which is basically the time period from the start of the amplitude until the end of the amplitude, and then you have the number of increments as well. So the number of increments basically means how many steps do you need within this period to increase and decrease your amplitude. So in this example, I have chosen 100 RPM as increasing and decreasing from the nominal. I have also chosen the period as 10 seconds and increment as 10, and this is, you can see here, so within a portion of the sign you will have 10 steps. So basically 10 steps going up, 10 steps coming down, again 10 steps going down, and 10 steps to go up back to the nominal. As the RPM is varying, there is the grind point, or just imagine a single diamond coming in contact with the blank at the same time has been avoided. Now, by using this one, you are able to remove the fish scale pattern on your peel ground blanks. The recommended amplitude is, I would probably not go more than 150 RPM from the nominal, and for finishing, I would not go more than 50. Again, this is dependent on the grinding wheels. You can probably ask our wheel suppliers to provide that data, and they will be able to tell us, because this variation in RPM should not counteract and give you more wheel wear. So we want to keep the wheel wear efficiency to be at the maximum without affecting the wear. At the same time, remove the fish scale pattern on the peel ground blanks. So here's another feature which is all about providing our users simple ways to manage quality and productivity on the machine. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for your time, and we will see you next time with another episode of Tooltip Tuesday.